Hi, Carl Winkler here at Lectrosonics. This is the first in a series of 5 videos where I'll be showing you a deep dive into the advanced features of the DSR4 digital slot receiver. The firmware versions that we're running in this unit are V1.05/1.01. If you have anything lower than that, you'll want to update your units with Wireless Designer and the .update file from our website so that you see the same features we're showing here. In this first video, I want to cover the fact that you can have any of the 4 receiver channels on different compatibility modes independently. For instance, receiver 1 can be set to D2 mode to work with a DPRA, receiver 2 could be set to NA hybrid to work with an older LT, receiver 3 can be set to new hybrid for an SMWB, and receiver 4 can be set to DCHX channel 1, let's say if you're using a DCHT as an IFB feed. This gives you the freedom to use whichever compatible transmitters you have, anything we've made in the past 20 years, with your new DSR4. Next is the tuning ranges of the units and the fact that all 4 receivers can be tuned anywhere within that range independently. For instance, in the A1-B1 range, you can have receiver 1 tuned to 470.750, receiver 2 at 591.800, receiver 3 at 510.125, and receiver 4 at 607.525 MHz. In other words, you have full freedom to move any of the 4 channels anywhere within the available tuning range, and you do not have to have them in any order. And in case you haven't discovered this yet, each receiver has a detail view. From the home screen, press the back button, and we will see detail view for channel 1, including the RF strip chart, frequency, block, and hex code for hybrid modes, tuning group if used, compat mode, link or pilot tone status, and audio levels. By using the up and down arrow keys, you can now navigate to each of the 4 channels. Pressing back again returns you to the home screen. Up next, how to use scanning and manual frequency selection in the DSR4. I'm Carl Winkler. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.